मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी आर डिस्कस द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी. फर्स्ट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन, ऑलरेडी बी डन इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो. देन सेकंड इज द ऑक्सीडेशन. सेकंड वन इज द ऑक्सीडेशन बेटा, ऑन कंप्लीट ऑक्सीडेशन. ऑन कंप्लीट ऑक्सीडेशन एल्कीन burn in air to give carbon dioxide, water and lot of energy. Suppose you have ethene. How many carbon? We have 2 carbon. It will oxidize to give 2 moles of carbon dioxide. Then how many hydrogen? 2. 2 moles of water. How many oxygen required? Total 6. Burning air. So on complete oxidation, every unsaturated or saturated hydrocarbon on complete oxidation, that will be burning air to give carbon dioxide and water, which release lot of energy. This process is known as combustion. Better, this process is known as combustion. Further, controlled oxidation. On controlled oxidation, that means oxidation under any catalyst. If alkene is oxidized in air in presence of silver, beta, one atom of silver or half molecule of oxygen will required for reaction of alkene with silver. It will give epoxides. Epoxide means cyclic ether. Only one oxygen atom will be consumed. It is known as epoxides or cyclic ether. Clear? Beta, if we have alkene, higher alkene, not matter. If we have both side any alkyl group, that is okay. If there is 2 alkyl group, then also okay. Clear? Cyclic ether will be formed in place of double bond. Then oxidation or controlled oxidation done with strong oxidizing agent, that is the KMnO4 or potassium dichromate K2CR27. With KMnO4, beta, we use KMnO4 in two condition, cold KMnO4 as well as hot KMnO4. With cold KMnO4, that means, beta, this reagent is known as Beer's reagent. Beer's reagent under cold condition, that means we have alkene, any alkene. We have alkene is oxidized in KMnO4 cold condition, that means heat is not required, with KH dissolved in water. Better, this will produce oxygen as much as you required. That oxygen, atomic oxygen, is known as nascent oxygen or atomic oxygen. Beta, it will give diol. It will give diol. Naming, IUPAC naming must be given according to their position. Otherwise, generally they are diol because they consist of 2 OH group. When Beer's reagent added to the alkene and heated, that means hot KMnO4, hot Beer's reagent, what will happen? When alkene is treated with Beer's reagent, beta, if we have CH, it will be oxidized finally into carbon dioxide and water. Suppose we have this one, beta, KMnO4, KOH, heat the solution, इट विल प्रोवाइड नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन एज मच एज यू रिक्वायर्ड. बेटा इट विल ऑक्सीडाइज दिस इनटू एसिड एंड फाइनली डीकम्पोज इनटू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर. क्लियर? हाउ मेनी ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायर्ड? 2 and 2, 4 ऑक्सीजन. एंड 2 हाइड्रोजन विल बी रिमूव इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर. दैट मीन्स वी रिक्वायर 5 ऑक्सीजन. देन 1 मोर ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायर्ड हेयर फॉर दिस. वी विल फॉर्म दिस वन इफ वी हैव दिस ग्रुप. देन वट हैपन बेटा? बाय यूजिंग दिस नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन इज रिक्वायर्ड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस बोन विल बी टोटली ब्रेक. इट विल गिव 2 एसिड्स. One acid with one carbon. And this is further oxidized to give carbon dioxide and water. This will remain stable. Clear? One more oxidation that is known as ozonolysis. Oxidation of alkene to aldehyde or ketone. This will be done with the help of ozone. In this reaction, ozone molecule decompose. Then this process is known as ozonolysis. Ozonolysis means breakdown. Breakdown of ozone take place in this reaction is known as ozonolysis reaction. Clear? Beta, general discussion. General alkene is this one. This ozone molecule decompose both the bone. It will decompose 2 bonds. If 1 bond is there, ozone does not work. 2 bond, both bond will break. If we have 3 bonds, 2 will break, 1 remains. Clear? And ozone break itself in 3 atoms of oxygen. Better this double bond will be broken down and ozone decompose itself just like this. And combine with each other to give ozonoid. This structure is known as ozonoid. And when this ozonoid heated with zinc dust, this zinc displaces this oxygen atom as zinc oxide and this bond will be break. We will get two bond empty with carbon, one with oxygen. Other one also have same. To complete the valency, we will apply double bond. They may be aldehyde or may be ketone. If this is symmetrical, 2 moles are formed. If these are unsymmetrical, 2 different forms are formed. Clear? This is ozonolysis. And then last property, third one is known as polymerization. Polymerization. Beta, polymerization of alkene follow free radical mechanism generally. Beta, generally it will follow free radical mechanism, but in some conditions it may follow cationic or anionic mechanism also. That means carbocation formed or maybe carboanion, that depends upon condition. Otherwise, it will follow free radical mechanism. Clear? That's not matter. Mechanism is not in our syllabus. Beta, you have ethene. Poly means many, mass means molecule. Large number of small molecule combined together to give a large size molecule with high molecular mass. And this large size molecule is useful for us. Beta, suppose you have ethene. Beta, poly means many, many molecules of ethene. Ethene itself a single molecule. Single means mono, mar means molecule. Single molecule or monomer. On heating strongly, it will show polymerization reaction. Clear? And large number of alkenes decompose its pi bond at free radical. Clear? And two odd electrons come together and they will form bond. In this way, large number of molecules will combine. So, in short, we will represent this as, this molecule consists of two carbon. You will represent like this. Large number of molecules, smaller molecule combine together to give a large molecule. That single is ethene, but many ethenes combine together. Many means poly. It is polyethene. Beta, it is same polyethene that we will use in our daily life very vigorously. It is known as polymer. And this reaction is known as polymerization reaction. Beta, all unsaturated compound, either alkene or alkyne, they will form polymer. Thank you.